Hey, this is Ben from Digital Mastery. I'm going to show you how to do something kind of crazy with Photoshop. That's right, I'm going to show you how to take something from the past, something you did 10 minutes ago, 15 minutes ago, and bring it into the future, bring it to now. Let's say you had a selection or a layer, and you wish you wouldn't have messed it up. You messed it up 10 minutes ago, and now you wish you could recover. How could you do it without any future planning or past planning either? And just grab it, go back in time, and bring it back to now. Let's do it. Get into it now. Here's a document I've done a lot too. I used to have layers that no longer exist. I used to have selections that no longer exist. I want to be able to get them back. How do you do it? Well, you know you can go back in time. You've done it before. You go to the edit menu. You have the choice of undo. You know the keyboard shortcut. We all screw up so often we have it plastered in our head. Command Z. I'm going to type Command Z multiple times and you can see me go back multiple steps in this document. And I can keep going back and back more and more steps, getting rid of retouching, getting rid of changes I've made, getting old selections back. But how do I take that selection that I had back in this point in time and get it back to the newest version of my document, the version I had the moment we started this video? Well, we can do it. All you need to do is make sure you do not change the document. Make sure the only thing you've done is choose undo, then do this. If it's a selection you need to get back in time, then go to the select menu. When that selection is on your screen, come down here and choose save selection, but be very careful because if you save that selection into this document, you're going to lose all the steps that you have undone, all those things you had done after this point in your document. So what you need to do is change this menu called document to new. Now you're going to have a brand new document that is going to have that selection built into it. So I'll click OK. And look, that is the selection right there as it would look if it was part of a mask. Now let's switch to the other tab. That's back to the old document we were in a minute ago, and go to the window menu. What you want to do under the window menu is come down here to history. History is going to list all of the steps that you undid to get back to this point in time. And don't click on anything except for the bottom most. That'll get you back to what your document looked like at the time you started to type Command Z to undo. Now let's get that selection in here. If I go to the select menu, I'm going to choose load selection. And as long as we have other documents of exactly the same size as this one, and we do, there's one called Untitled One, I can tell it to load a selection from that other document. I click OK. And now I have the selection that we saved into that separate document. And it's back here. My document is just like it was when we started. Let's do the same for layers. I used to have this little round thing over here on its own layer. I don't anymore. I so wish I did. So let's type Command Z. And as I do, you can watch right in the history panel as we back up more than more steps. I'll simply look in my layers panel and right there, I see the layer appear. I can see a tiny little life preserver in there. I want to somehow get that layer forward in time. How do I do it? Here's how it's done. We got to be very careful not to change anything in this document. Otherwise, whatever's in the history list is going to disappear after the spot we're in. So we got to be careful not to change which layer's active or anything like that. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to hold down the Option key. That's Alt in Windows. I'm going to click but not let go on this layer, and I'm going to drag it down to the new layer icon. Remember, I have Option, Alt in Windows held down. I'm going to then let go. It thinks I want to duplicate the layer. If I do that, it's going to add a step to my history, and it's going to throw away all those steps that are after it, so I'm going to lose work. But right here, again, it asks me, what document do I want that duplicate to appear in? And I say a brand new document. And I click OK. You can see I have a brand new tab. It has that layer within it. Now I go back to the tab I was working in, and I don't change anything in this document except for here in the history panel. I go to the very bottom step in the history panel. That will get me back to where I was at the time I started this video. And now I want to get that layer in here. So what do? I go to that other document, the document that has our duplicate layer in it. I hold down the Option key, Alt in Windows, one more time, and I drag it down to the new layer icon one more time. In this time, I'm telling it to duplicate the layer, and I can tell it what document to put it in. I tell it to put it in the original document. I click OK, and now it zoomed up. That was just because if you hold down the Option key and you click on the name of a layer, it will zoom up. But if I return to this document, now check out, we have a layer right there, a layer that we didn't have when I started this video. This was a layer I made earlier, and I was able to get it back. So anytime you want to go back in time, you want to either type Command Z to go back steps or just click here on the steps that are in the history panel, and you can go back in time. You go back until you find the element that you wanted back in time. And once you find it, if it's a selection and it's active on your screen, then you want to go up to the select menu and choose save selection and save it into that other document. Or on the other hand, if it's a layer, what you wanted to do is hold down the option key, Alt and Windows, drag that layer down to the new layer icon. Just be very careful when you do. Do not click and let go on the layer. You want to only let go when your mouse is on top of that new layer icon. Otherwise, you'll screw up what's in the history panel. Now, your history panel with default settings only contains 50 steps, and you can easily get rid of 50 steps very quickly, especially when doing things like making selections. You make a small area of a selection, you hold shift to add to it, and add a little more, and a little more, and a little more. Each one of those additions is a new step in your history panel, so this can very quickly get past that 50-step maximum. So, go up to your Photoshop menu if you're on a Mac, that'd be the Edit menu in Windows, and choose Preferences. And in your preferences, you want to go to a section called Performance. And in Performance, you will find a setting called History States. And History States should be called Undos. The default setting is 50. That tells you how many undos you're going to be able to have in Photoshop. That tells you how long your history list can be. I usually bring mine up to 150, but you can go even higher than that if you'd like to. Then you can click OK. If you want to do more with this, you can. This surfboard used to be a different color, so I could back up in my history until it is that other color. And if you look, there is a little icon in the left column right here. It looks like a brush with a little U-turn symbol on it. You will find the same brush over here in your tools panel. It's right below your retouching tools. It's called the history brush. And all it does is it paints with what your document used to look like. So if I go to my background layer, which contains that, and I look at where my history brush is set, it's set to paint with my original version of my document. That's always what the top step is in your history panel. And I could come down here and paint with what color that surfboard used to be. Or I could move forward in my history to right before this, right before I painted with the history. And now I'm going to be painting with the other version, and I can bring it back. So experiment with the history brush as well, and know that you can change what it's painting with. It defaults to painting with your original document as it looked when you first opened it. You will have a limitation, though, if you change the mode of your picture or its dimensions, its width and height in pixels, then the history brush will not work.
Wasn't that nuts? Why don't they build something like that in the Photoshop? Why can't I go up to the menu and choose select, reselect, and just give me a list? After all, it's storing all that stuff. Well, now you can. You just need to do a little bit of work. I'll see you next time. I'm Ben Wilmore.